Mary Alexander from Home Instead Senior Care, and today I'm talking about diabetes. Diabetes is a group of diseases characterized by high blood glucose levels. Our bodies break down most food into glucose and then use it to fuel our systems. In order for the glucose to get into our cells, it needs insulin. In people with diabetes, their pancreas either produces little or no insulin, or the cells do not respond appropriately to the insulin. Generally, there are three types of diabetes. First is type 1, which is usually diagnosed in children and young adults. In type 1 diabetes, our body does not produce insulin. The second and most common form is type 2 diabetes. In this case, either the body does not produce enough insulin or the cells ignore it altogether. The third form of diabetes is gestational diabetes, which occurs during pregnancy. There is also a condition called prediabetes. People with prediabetes almost always have blood glucose levels that are higher than normal, but not yet high enough to be diagnosed as diabetes. Sadly, diabetes is very common. According to data from the 2011 Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, 25.8 million children and adults in the United States have diabetes, and another 79 million people have prediabetes. Men and women are affected nearly equally. Over one quarter of seniors aged 65 and older have diabetes, and in general, the Hispanic, African American, Asian American, and Native American communities have greater prevalence of this disease. Diabetes also carries a significant financial toll. In 2007, the total cost of diabetes in the United States was $218 billion. Knowing how to prevent diabetes and fully understanding its symptoms are your best defenses to stopping this disease and its ramifications in its tracks.